Your email can be very overwhelming. You should check your email daily. It is the official communication method for the college, so you want to be sure you aren't missing important information or updates. Professors, advisors, and other staff will communicate with you by email. Here are 10 tips to help you stay on top of the information you are getting in email. Tip number one, forward your email. If you only want to check one of your email accounts regularly, you can forward your email to the account that you check daily. Go to Settings, See All Settings, select Forwarding and pop/IMAP. Read the details on forwarding carefully to be sure you're doing what you want. Tip number two, notifications on your iPhone. Set up notifications on your phone so that you can see what emails are coming into your account. That way, if a professor emails you with some important information, you will know that you need to check your email when you get a chance. On an iPhone, go to Settings, Notifications, scroll down to Gmail, and click on Allow Notifications. Other phones have similar features. Tip number three, organizing and sorting email. Gmail now sorts email by primary, social, and promotions. Be sure to check your social and promotions folders periodically. In your primary inbox, the default setting is to have read and unread email in the order they were received. If an email is important or it requires a response or some action, you can mark it unread. You can also change the default setting by going into Settings, under Quick Settings, scroll down to Inbox Type, and select Unread First. Unread emails will appear on the top of your list, so you can see those first and can prioritize them. If you scroll down below unread messages, you can see everything else. You can also use stars to indicate categories or importance and to sort. Tip number four, set up a separate email account you can use for junk mail. Every time you get asked for your email at a store or when you sign up for something not very important, give out your junk email address instead. This will help you to avoid unnecessary clutter in your email. If you are getting regular clutter messages, email messages that you don't want, go into the email and find the unsubscribe option. Tip number five, using labels. Labels are like folders and help you organize the emails that you want to keep. Regularly label and put away emails that you don't need to take action on. Select the label icon and start typing some part of the label name that you want to use, and it will autofill. You can find emails later by looking in the folder. Tip number six, search function. Another way to find an email is by using the search function. You can search by the name of the person who sent the email or by some word that is in the email. For the best results, add as many search features as possible or use something unique that will help you to locate what you're looking for. For example, if I'm looking for a specific group email, I search for an individual that I don't usually email, along with a few unique words that the email might contain. There it is. Tip number seven, use delete carefully. Only delete messages that you absolutely no longer need. Once you delete them, they are gone. Sometimes they're saved in your trash for 30 days, but eventually they will be gone. Check out the archive feature as well. Tip number eight, schedule send. If you're working and/or emailing late at night or early in the morning, you should be aware that some people have notifications turned on and could be woken up by your email. Instead of hitting send, select schedule send and set a time for the email to be sent, like 8 or 9 a.m. Tip number nine, check your draft folder. If you start an email and get distracted and don't hit send, it will be stored in your draft folder. Check your draft folder regularly to see if you see an email that you didn't actually send. Also, delete any drafts that you don't need to keep and finish later. Tip number 10, email etiquette and expectations. Emails should be professionally written with a title in the subject line, addressed appropriately, and be well constructed with no slang or spelling errors. They are not like texting, which is much more informal. Also, you should not expect an immediate response from an email. Some people will respond to email within 24 to 48 business hours. If you must have a quicker response, you can try labeling an email urgent, but only if it really is urgent. Staying on top of your emails is one of the keys to academic and personal success. Good luck!